On the clearest of nights, when the winds of the Aetherium were calm and peaceful, the great merchant ships with their cargoes of Arcturian solar crystals felt safe and secure. Little did they suspect that they were pursued by pirates. And the most feared of all these pirates was the notorious Captain Nathaniel Flint. Flint and his band of renegades swooped in out of nowhere. And then, gathering up their spoils, vanished without a trace.
Well, certainly a lot of trouble over that odd little sphere. Those markings baffle me. Unlike anything I've ever encountered. Even with my vast experience and superior intellect, it would take me years to unlock its... Hey!
What? It's a map!
Wait! This is us, the planet Montressor. That's the Magellanic Cloud.
Woo!
The Coral Galaxy. That's the Cygnus Cross. And that's the Carrion Abyss. Wait, what's this? What? It's...
Treasure Planet.
No.
That's Treasure Planet.
Flint's Trove? The Loot of a Thousand Worlds? You know what this means?
Hey!
Ah, there you are, Jim. I've been tinkering with this map device, and I've made some startling discoveries.
What are we doing here? We need to get to the planet before anyone else gets there.
Treasure Planet!
Jim, it's that sort of attitude that will get you into serious trouble. You see, the map is somehow linked to these ancient navigational beacons. Italian astronomic records show that there are hundreds of these beacons scattered all over the galaxy. I've located a pocket of them right here on Montressor. Jim, it is up to you to go find these beacons and see if you can activate them. I don't think you'll need any special equipment to open the beacons. Keep your wits about you. You may have to perform a task to get the job done.
Don't worry, Doc. We'll be back as quick as an Alponian solar cruiser. Right, Mor?
Alponian solar cruiser.
Hello there, Boyle.
I see you made the acquaintance of your old pal Murphy here.
Murphy!
Oh, heavens, I wondered where you'd got to. I hadn't seen you for ages.
You know Morph?
That I do. And it be John Silver at your service, sir. Cook, handyman, and just between you and me, a bit of a scallywag. The docs hired me to be looking after the galley on this excursion of yours. So, we'll be seeing a lot of each other. Murphy here, he's an adaptable little fella. If you ever need to whack at something that's a bit stubborn, like them buttons say, just press the jump button, followed by the attack button, and Murphy will hammer it into submission for you. Go, Trapdoons, lad. A spacefarer's most treasured possession. Collect around 100 of them in each area that you reach, and you'll activate another beacon. I've been checking up on these peculiar-looking pads, and I reckon that they'll be right useful to our little friend Morph here. I figures that these'll give him the strength of a cyborg, say. Might be useful if you have a need to break open anything tougher than timber. Just press the jump button over the pad, and Morph will give you all the strength you need. They're pretty useful for picking things up, too. Try crouching near a barrel and you'll see what your new muscles can do. Watch out though, matey. These things never last for long.
All right!
Jimbo. You'll find these here green energies wherever you roam. And that's enough of them. And it's a beacon you'll be getting. This type of pad lets him morph into a spare hand for flipping switches. Ain't that right, little one?
Flipping switches!
If you ever come across a switch that's too big for you, find one of these pads and press the jump button. Morphy'll do the switching for you. But you've only got a wee bit of time before the effect wears off, so best be quick about it.
Huh!
Up to you.